Hello everyone, I am Miss Pratiksha Singh welcoming you to our next educational video of Physics Paper 2. And here we are going to start third unit, that is analog electronics. And in this video we will study about oscillators. And here we will discuss about introduction to oscillator and the types of oscillators. Okay, now what exactly oscillators are? It is an electronic circuit that generates periodic waveform on its output with only the DC supply as an input, and that is called as oscillators. Oscillators are also called as signal generator. Here only DC supply is given as an input and periodic waveform is generated as an output. That's why the circuit is called as signal generator and the another name is oscillator. It is also defined as a circuit that generates AC output signal having sine, square, triangular or sawtooth or pulse shape without the help of external input signal. Now, it is also an unstable amplifier which converts DC energy into AC energy at a very high frequency or at desired frequency. An amplifier is basically an energy converter. It receives energy from DC power source and converts it into AC energy at any signal frequency. So AC input signal controls the process of energy conversion. In the absence of input signal, no energy conversion is taking place, having no output. But what happens in oscillator? Oscillator does not require any external signal either to begin or to mount the energy conversion process. It produces sustained oscillation. So as long the DC power source is connected, the frequency of oscillation depends on passive components used in an oscillator circuit. Okay, and that passive components may be can change as per our will. So oscillators are commercially used in stereo amplifiers, radio and television transmitters, receivers, radars, etc. So here in this video we will discuss definition of oscillator and the types of oscillator. So let us begin. Introduction. An oscillator is an autonomous circuit that converts DC power into periodic waveform or a AC supply. Oscillators are extensively used in both receive and transmit paths. They are used to provide the local oscillation for the mixers for up and down conversion. This is introduction to oscillator. Now let us have types of oscillators. The first type is a phase shift oscillator. This oscillator is a linear electronic oscillator circuit that produces a sine wave as an output. And it consists of an inverting amplifier element such as a transistor or op-amp. Op-amp means operational amplifier, with its output feedback to its input through a phase shift network consisting of resistors and capacitors in a ladder network. The feedback network shifts the phase of the amplifier output by 180 degrees at the oscillation frequency just to give positive feedback, and therefore it is used as audio frequency as a audio oscillators. So a phase shift oscillator is widely used as a audio oscillators. Now you can see the diagram of phase shift oscillator. If we are interested to calculate the frequency of oscillation, so that can be found by using a simple formula, that is 1 upon 2 pi under root 6 C and into R. Now what is C and R? C is the capacitance of capacitor which is connected to this oscillator, and R is the resistance of the resistor which is also connected across this oscillator. So frequency of oscillation of the phase shift oscillator can be found as f0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root 6 c into r. This is about first type, that is phase shift oscillator. Now let us see second type, that is Colpitts oscillator. A Colpitts oscillator invented in 1918 by American engineer Edwin H. Colpitts is one of a number of designs for LC oscillator. This oscillator is designed by L and C components. L means inductor and C means capacitors. So electronic oscillators that use a combination of inductors and capacitors is called as a Colpitts oscillator, and it is used to produce an oscillation at a certain frequency. The distinguishing feature of the Colpitts oscillator is that feedback for the active device is taken from a voltage divider made up of two capacitors in a series across the inductor. If you see in diagram, you can see here the two capacitors are connected across in series across the inductor. The frequency of oscillation is approximately the resonant frequency of the LC circuit, which is the series combination of the two capacitors in parallel with the inductor. So that's why formula becomes F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L and C. Now what is L? L is the inductance of the inductor that is connected in Colpitts oscillator, and C is the capacitance of the capacitor that is connected across the inductor. So here C is the equivalent value of the capacitance. If there are two capacitors are connected, then we can calculate C as a C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. So formula for frequency becomes F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L and in bracket C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. As the both capacitors are connected in series combination, then the total capacitance can be found, or equivalent capacitance can be found, by using C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2 formula. So that's why the frequency of oscillation of a Colpitts oscillator can be found by using the formula F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. And if there is only one capacitor connected in this oscillator, then the formula becomes F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L and only C. So this was about second oscillator, that is a Colpitts oscillator. Now let us have a look on third type of oscillator, that is a Wien bridge oscillator. It is a type of electronic oscillator that generates sine waves, and it can generate a large range of frequencies. The oscillator is based on a bridge circuit, that's why it is called as Wien bridge oscillator, and it is originally developed by Max Wien scientist in 1891 just for the measurement of the impedances. So that's why the name of this oscillator is given as Wien bridge oscillator. The bridge comprises four resistors and two capacitors. The oscillator can also be viewed as a positive gain amplifier combined with a bandpass filter that provides a positive feedback. So here also the frequency of oscillation can be found by using formula F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root R1 C1 into R2 C2. Since there are two resistors connected in this oscillator and two capacitors are also connected, so the formula becomes R1 C1 into R2 C2. But if the values of both resistors or if the resistances of both resistors are same, then it may be written as R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R. Similarly, if the capacitance of the two capacitors are equal, then it may be written as C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C. So the formula for frequency of oscillation becomes F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi RC. So this was about third oscillator, that is a Wien bridge oscillator. Now let us see fourth oscillator, fourth and the last type of oscillator, that is the Hartley oscillator. This is an electronic oscillator circuit in which oscillation frequency is determined by tuned circuit consisting of capacitors and inductors. that is an LC oscillator. This oscillator is also called as LC oscillator. As it is discovered by Hartley, then it is also known as Hartley oscillator. But the components which are connected in this oscillator are a capacitor and an inductor. That's why it is also called as L and C oscillator. The circuit was invented in 1915 by American engineer Ralph Hartley. So, on his honor, the oscillator is named as Hartley oscillator. The distinguishing feature of the Hartley oscillator is that the tuned circuit consists of a single capacitor in a parallel with two inductors in series, or a single tap inductor. The feedback signal needed for oscillation is taken from the center connection of the two inductors. Now, here also we are interested to find the frequency of oscillation, frequency of one oscillation of this Hartley oscillator, and that may be given as f is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root Lt into C. Now here, C is the capacitance of the capacitor which is connected across this oscillator. But what is Lt? Lt is the L1 plus L2 plus 2m, as it is the addition of both inductors plus 2 into m that gives you a value of Lt. So the frequency of oscillation of this Hartley oscillator may be count as or may be measured as f is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root Lt into C. So this was about fourth oscillator. So in short, we have been seen what exactly was oscillators and the types of oscillator. That was a phase shift oscillator, a Colpitts oscillator, a Wien bridge oscillator, and lastly we have seen Hartley oscillator. And these oscillators are commercially used in stereo amplifiers, radio and television communications, and transmitters and receivers, and radars, and so for all communication systems. High frequency oscillators are also used in some industries as well. So here we have completed the main topic, that is oscillators and the types of oscillator. Write this concept in your notebook. We will meet in next video with new unit. Till then, thank you and bye-bye.